Hello, friends. It is Monday, May 11th, and good to be back with you after a week off. It was nice to just take a little break and work in my yard, which is where I usually do my best thinking and processing and reflecting, but also good to get some or to tackle some projects that have been sitting around for a while. So it was good to have that time. Thanks for give me that time each year to have some vacation time. Even when we can't go anywhere, it was good to just take the time here at home. So thanks for that. I hope everyone had a great weekend, great week last week. And for all the moms out there, I hope you had a wonderful Mother's Day yesterday. I'm sure it was somewhat bittersweet in that you probably couldn't really be with your loved ones like you normally would. As Pastor Dave said in his message yesterday, normally you'd probably go out to brunch or some kind of a meal and weren't able to do that. But hopefully you still found ways to connect with loved ones, and hopefully you were still blessed in the process. So I just know how grateful and thankful we all are. As Pastor Dave said, I will reiterate for the moms out there, for the just the strong women out there and in our congregation, we're grateful for you. And for any of those who for whom yesterday was maybe a tough day, I just hope and pray that you were able to find some peace yesterday, and hopefully it was a day of reflecting. Maybe by where normally everyone, a lot of people are out celebrating with moms, maybe the fact that everyone was isolated and couldn't do that as much, maybe that actually brought you some peace, knowing that you weren't the only one who wasn't doing that, or maybe was having a tough time on Mother's Day. So if Mother's Day is typically a difficult day for you, I hope yesterday was actually a good day and hopefully brought you some peace and maybe a time to reflect on that. And yeah, again, hopefully you can find ways to be kind of a spiritual mother. As Pastor Dave said, a spiritual mother to others in our congregation, other people in our community who might be in need of that. I think that's there's a great need for that, for spiritual mothers and fathers and being mentors. So I just affirm that as well. So friends, today I just mainly wanted to jump back on here and say hello again. And I really, truly hope that you all are doing well and staying well and that your families are as well. And just know that you all remain in my prayers and my thoughts, and I'll be eager to see you all when we're able to do so again. Obviously, as of now, at least for the foreseeable future, we're not going to be able to be gathering as a large congregation for our gatherings, our larger gatherings. So we're going to continue to just try to adapt and find ways to still connect with you, whether it's through sending out emails like Pastor Dave has been doing, or for me jumping on and sending these video messages now and again. Probably won't be as regular as I had done through April, and definitely not as long as each one was then, but I still want to use this format and this platform as ways to connect with you. So glad I can do that. So again, we'll just keep hoping and praying that an end will come soon to this COVID-19 and this pandemic, and we can get back together. But again, I just want to remind us, I said this in my newsletter article, the goal, I really believe this should not be just to how do we get back to the way things were. I think even though I don't believe in any way that God caused this pandemic, I truly believe God is working through it and has lots that he wants to teach us and ways he wants to grow us through it. And so I think we would be wise to be attentive to that and be listening and discerning of what he might be trying to teach us. So as we look ahead, even though, yes, we desire to get back together, to see one another, of course, we also want to be thinking about how do we need to be different? How should things look different than they did before this? What things do we want to get back to? What things should we not get back to? What things should we just let go of and not continue to do? And then also, what new things should we be pursuing? Obviously, this whole digital piece that was really minimal in our ministry at Emmanuel before all this, it's become our primary tool currently. And even when we go back to in-person, it still should remain a primary tool for us. Online really is now the new front door, as opposed to people just showing up at your door. That really doesn't happen, or at your church building, that really doesn't happen anymore. at least very infrequently. So we want to be thinking about online and digital as really a front door for us and how we can be doing even more with that, as well as other new things. I just want to really encourage us to be open to new endeavors, to new ways that the Spirit is leading and guiding us forward. So with that in mind, I just want to share a brief Bible passage here today. Actually, just one verse that I think is really applicable and appropriate for this. As we don't know what the future holds. God does. We don't. We'd like to know. We want that control. We want that sense of peace around that. But right now, there remains a lot of uncertainty. And that just reminded me of when Joshua takes over from Moses, and Joshua is the one who's going to lead the people, the Israelites, into the promised land. There was so much uncertainty. What he knew for certain was that God had promised it and God would fulfill it. But they had to faithfully follow God, and they hadn't done the best job of doing that. So there was all this uncertainty. Even though Joshua knew that God was in control, that God was leading and guiding, he still didn't know exactly what that would look like. And here was God's word for him. Have I not, Joshua chapter 1, verse 9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened. Do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. I think that's a great word for us today, as this is very familiar. Maybe it's not entering a promised land necessarily, but I think God has some great promises in front of us that he intends to fulfill in us and through us. And he's calling us to trust him. And to, even when we can't see what it's going to look like, even when there's uncertainty and fear and concern and all those things, he's saying, do you trust me? I've given you a commandment to be strong and courageous. And even more so, I think, for us now than for Joshua, we know that all of our mistakes, all of our sins have already been wiped clean. They've been accounted for by Jesus' death on the cross and his resurrection. And so we should have even greater confidence than Joshua, as we've already been given the promise of eternal life. It's already ours. So I guess in that way, we're very similar to those Israelites. They had the promise of the promised land. We have the promise of eternal life. So any fears we have really should be mitigated because of that, that we can say, hey, we're going to go into and step into whatever God calls us to, because we already know that he's taking care of the big thing. And now we get to step into these new endeavors to share that good news with others, to reach new people with the love of Christ, and to just bring the kingdom to bear here as well. So I hope you're encouraged by that word. Spend some more time. Joshua chapter 1, again, that phrase, be strong and courageous, is repeated multiple times throughout Joshua. But I encourage you to spend some time with that and reflect on that here as just a good word for us today. So God bless you. Good to be back with you, and I'll be talking with you soon. Take care.